Where is this place? Where can we meet God? Where is God? Where is His presence? Where can I go? So listen to me. Write this down. This is powerful. Relationship is the place from where we pray. Relationship is the place where from we pray. I'm going to say it again. I want you to understand that, young people, please, adults, please, listen to me. Relationship is the place where we pray. Relationship. What do you mean, Apostle? Relationship. Write it down. Relationship means, listen, communion means fellowship. Listen. Communion, fellowship, communication, prayer. So, fellowship, communication, common union, communion, relationship with who? Jesus said, enter in your room and speak to yourself. To who? Say, to my Father. Come on, say it louder, people. So he said, prayer is a place. How the place is called. First, it's called relationship. Relationship means fellowship, means communion, means communication, means prayer. Listen, if you do not have relationship with God as your Father, you just another religious person. Why? Because most of the religions of the world today, none of them relate to God as Father. Most of the religion today, listen, most of the religions today, their gods are dead. How come you will have communication with the dead idol? How come you will have relationship with a dead God? Come on, wake up. How come you're going to have relationship with someone that don't talk? Don't smile, don't laugh, don't, nothing. So listen, prayer starts from a place. What's the name of the place? Lift your hands, hey. Relationship means what? Fellowship, communication, prayer, common union. That means if you remove yourself from the place of relationship with the Father, with God as your Father, listen, what you ended up with, just a religion. Because you don't have any results, any change, any nothing in your life if there's no relationship. And if you don't have any and you call yourself Christian, there's a problem. You got a religion. Why? Because most of those religion, all of them, their God is dead. So how come you will have a personal relationship with a dead God? So it's a place. So I'm talking this morning about a place called relationship. Say it again. Relationship. So this place is called relationship. Some of the time Jesus said, listen to me. He said, when you come, verse 6 of Matthew, goes to Matthew again, verse 6. But you, when you pray, enter into a closet. And then shut the door. Pray to the Father that is in, what is the name? That secret place is called relationship, communication. That is the place where you enter to pray. That is the place where you develop your communication with your Father. That is the place where you okay. I want you to write this down. In the Old Testament, most of the people did not know God as Father. But there was a place where people come to meet God. In the New Testament, Jesus said, secret place. In the Old Testament, are you writing this down? In the Old Testament, it was called Holies of Holies. In the Old Testament, it was called a place called there. It was called Holies of Holies, where the presence of God was. It was called different names. That place that in the New Testament is called relationship. It was called Holies of Holies. It was called, listen, it was called a place called there. Where is it, Pastor? Genesis chapter, if somebody help me, please. Genesis chapter 28, verse 16 and 17.
Then Jacob awoke from his sleep and said, surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it.
In what?
This place, and I did not know it.
Verse 11. Verse 11.
So he came to a certain place.
Hey! Came to where?
Certain place.
And what happened?
And he stayed there all night because the sun had set. And he took one of the stones of that place and put it at his head, and he lay down in that place to sleep.
In that place, certain place. Ho, 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 ho. Okay, listen, write this down, please. In the mind of God, there's a place called there. And that's when the Old Testament was talking about called there. Matthew chapter 18, verse 20.
For where two or three are gathered together in my name, I am there.
Hey! Okay, so Jesus said, if you come together, two of you come together in agreement, in my name, not in your denomination, in my name, I will be there. So before we said that the place where we prayed from is a call place, relationship. That place in the Old Testament is called, say it. Right, what is there? Write it down. There is the place where God planned and purposed that he would meet you and he will have an encounter with you. Now, you didn't get it. You didn't get it. No, I know you didn't get it. It's the place where God planned and purposed that he would meet you there. And he will have an encounter with you. Listen, in other words, every single day God is saying, Patricia, John, Mark, I meet you in a place. Jesus said, your closet. Revelation today is relationship. That place where you go, it doesn't matter if it's your car. It doesn't matter if it's your bathroom. It doesn't matter where it is. But there is a place called there with God every day has purposed is where the place where God had planned and purposed, and God said, in your car is the place of romance. In your bathroom is the place where I will give you your breakthrough. In your house, in your closet, is the place where I will change your family. We will meet there. We will meet. It doesn't matter how the physical place is. God is saying, it's the place of you and I communicating, communion, loving each other. Touch your neighbor and tell him, a place called there. Listen, practical, simple, and powerful. Where is there? Where God said, son and daughter, this is the place where I planned and purpose to have an encounter every day with you. This is the place where we will communicate. This is the place of our relationship. If you don't have any, you don't have me. Why? Because how come you said that you believe in the risen Christ and you don't have any relationship? How can you say, how can I say, I do have a relationship? How can you say if your husband or your wife died 5 years ago and then you're saying now, I got a good relationship with my wife, she's dead. How come you have a personal communication, communion with a God that is alive, and then you don't hear him, you don't see anything, you don't perceive anything? How come? That is religion. I did not bring you into the church to have a religion. I'm going to teach you how to communicate with your Father, to communicate with your God, to communicate, to have that relationship with him. Wow, I love this one. Okay. A place called, a place called, lift your hands quickly. No, quickly, lift your hands, say it with me. Say, prayer is a place of relationship where I pray from. Prayer is a place called there where God has planned and purpose to meet me and have an encounter together. That is not religion. That is, lift your hand and say, that is my living Christ. Wow. Now, you ordained it. Oh, now, knowing this, Jesus said, it's called a secret place. So Jesus said, this place, prayer, is the place. Is that the physical? No. Physical, you just look for a place where you feel from God. When I used to work in secular jobs, I remember I went to my car and I pray every 1 hour every day in my car. And that was my secret place. That was the place called there. Pastor, you got a big house. I don't have a big house. Listen, I used to pray in my bathroom. For almost 3 years, my house was, my efficiency was so small, and I pray in my bathroom, but I didn't feel the smelling, because the presence of God was so strong. That was my place. It doesn't matter, but I felt God in my bathroom. I love him. We have romance. We love him. We communicate with him. I heard his voice in the bathroom. In the bathroom. It doesn't matter. God said, the place that I appointed, that I planned, that's the place we meet. And that's the place I will change your character. I will change your... That's the place where you learn to hear my voice. I'm going to create a hunger for prayer. I'm going to create you a hunger for prayer. See, they have taught you so many bad things about prayer that you said, man, it doesn't make sense to me. I want to pray. When you understand there's a place of relationship, we call relationship. And from that relationship is where, oh, Write this down. Write this down. This is so powerful. Write this down. Prayer is the place of, once you got that relationship set every day, once you got that presence, that communication with God. Pastor, I talk, but I don't hear anything. That's the problem. This is one of the greatest weapons of the enemy to stop you from prayer. When you hear something in your mind, thoughts coming into your mind and tells you, that is me, that's not God. The devil always makes you think is your thoughts, are your thoughts, not God's voice. That's what you said, I don't hear anything. So Jesus is a liar. Then if you don't promise, he will manifest to me when I seek him. Of course he talks. Of course he's alive. So what happened? When you get into that place, God, I set a place to pray. I feel led to do it in my closet, my bathroom, my car. It doesn't matter. From that place of relationship with the Father, Jesus called it a secret place. The Old Testament called it the holiest of holies. In the Old Testament, it was called there. It's where God has plan and purpose. In other words, there is a place and there is a time where God wants to meet you.